Hey, what's up, guys? Today, I just want to talk to you about some possible trades or free agent signing for the Montreal Canadiens during the offseason. So, the first thing the Habs should be looking at is a goal scorer. We have none of those in Montreal right now. You could see it in the series against Pittsburgh and against Philly. We had trouble scoring goals, and we had the young kids kind of step up during the season, during the offseason, I mean. Even then, it was rough. Like, our point production, like, point per game was rough. And we had like two or three games where the Habs got shut out. So, here are some potential trades or free agent signing that the Habs should go for, in my opinion. So, first of all, we got Patrick Laine. This guy is on the trade bait list for some reason. I feel like the Winnipeg Jets are looking to improve their depth at center and to fix holes in their defense, and the Habs are willing to trade Domi or Dano. Those are two great centerpieces that could greatly benefit Winnipeg, and you could like sweeten the deal with like adding a defenseman, like maybe Victor Mete or Brett Kulak, something like that. I know they played really well in the playoffs, but it would be a deal sweetener to like make it so the Winnipeg Jets want to trade him more. So Patrick Laine, he would really help the Habs with the goal scoring problem. This guy is a pure goal scorer. Like, he's for sure gonna score 40 goals sometime in his career. And the Jets don't seem to mind trading him because they have so many talented wingers and they really struggle in the middle. That's the main thing. If you look at a guy like Dano, for example, he came in sixth for the. Shit, what's the trophy's name? So Dano came in sixth in the Selke Trophy nomination. So that means he almost had enough point to make it into a no to be not nominated for it. And that just shows how good of a centerman he is and how key role he could play in Winnipeg since their problems are mostly on defense. Like, let's be honest, if they didn't have Connor Hellebuyck in net, this team would have been the worst team in the West, probably. So that's why I think that it could benefit both teams to make that trade. All right, so next trade idea, Jesse Puljujärvi. This guy is definitely not going to sign with Edmonton, and I think that Edmonton should look to trade him so they could get something in return, like draft picks, depth players, or like, because they need help on the wing. Because outside of McDavid and Draisaitl, there's not much happening there. Let's be honest, this team is really struggling outside of those two. They need goaltending, they need more depth scoring, and they need better defense. So you can pick pretty much anything, and I believe that Edmonton would be willing to trade Puljujärvi to the Habs or to any team that like offers something in exchange, because they're just gonna lose him if they don't trade him. I think that for the Habs, he could be in the top six probably, and he could put on some points. Like we saw it this year, he played in the Finnish league, and he was a beast over there. Let's be honest, this guy, he's a young kid, and a lot of people call him a flop, but I believe he still has potential, and he could make a comeback to the NHL next season. All right, so another potential trade. This one's more of a long shot because I don't think this team is gonna be willing to trade him without a big ask. Anthony Mantha of the Detroit Red Wings is in the trade talks, and I believe that if the Habs can go and sign him, he's a kid from Quebec, and you know how Habs fans, they love their kids from Quebec playing for the team. It's like a dream come true for every kid playing hockey in Montreal or in the whole of Quebec, and he would probably love to come play here. It's just I don't know if Steve Yzerman is willing to trade him. I believe he's just gonna give him probably a 3-year contract or something like that, or he's gonna try to lock him up for a long time. Because this guy is really good, but being on Detroit, it really like doesn't help your chances in this league. All right, so our first free agent I want to talk about is Ilya Kovalchuk. He played for Montreal in the beginning, well, not really beginning, but like he came in like somewhere in the middle of the season, and he really helped the Habs find their game. He helped them score goals on the power play, score goals 5-on-5, and he was just a really key presence that helped the Habs score goals, which is the main problem with this team. They struggle to score goals, and most of their wins are Carey Price standing on his head and just not letting anything through. And the Habs, all they have to do is score like one or two grinder goal, you know, like everybody in front of the net just pushing the puck in. And they don't need that many goals. They just have to like turtle and don't let high like danger shot go through. But if they could score goals, it would help Carey Price so much. Like for the past, I think, 4 years, he has been left to dry over there. And I think like scoring goals is really a key point here. And Kovalchuk can score goals. He also said he also really enjoyed it in Montreal, his time in Montreal, and the fans loved him too. So I think it would be a great deal. Maybe like a 1 year deal, and then you trade him again at the deadline or something if we don't make the playoff again, which I don't think we would. I think we will make the playoff this year. The young guys are looking like they stepped up their game, and we got a lot of prospects coming into next season. It should be really interesting to watch. So the next one I want to talk about is Torrey Krug. This guy has been insane in the past couple of years, and he's one of the biggest free agents out there. And I think that if Marc Bergevin can get his hands on him, that would be really, really helpful for the blue line in Montreal. He can put up a lot of points. He can hit hard. Like we've seen him, like the hit where he lost his helmet and he just ran across the ice to hit a guy and blew him up in the playoffs last year. And I just think that this guy is really insane, and Marc Bergevin should be looking to trade for him or for his rights, and or signing if he gets to free agency. All right, there's another one I want to talk about, and it's Mikko Koivu. So this one would be a bit more of a depth signing, but I think that he's a good veteran presence. He can play a really key role in on the penalty kill and like help out in the on the defensive side and shut down these big lines that exist across the league. He's been a leader for a long, long time, and I think he could really help like the young guys like Suzuki and Kotkaniemi like better their game more on the defensive side, because they can score goals. We saw that in the playoffs, but if they get better defensively and more responsible, this team, it could make a really big difference as to how the Habs play. Another possible signing for the Habs would be Bobby Ryan. He just got let go by the Sens recently, and I believe that he still has a lot of hockey to play to him. And he's a great veteran presence, and I think a young team like the Habs could benefit greatly from that. He was just getting back into the game. We saw it. I think one of his last games, he scored a hat trick, and he can still play hockey for sure. And I think that he is a great leader, and I don't know what Ottawa was thinking. I guess it's just the contract was too big for his role. But if the Habs can sign him to like a cheap deal for like maybe a year or two, a veteran presence up front could really benefit the young Habs player. And now finally, the last one. I don't know if this one's gonna happen. He is a free agent and he can score a lot of goals. It's Mike Hoffman. So as I said a lot during this video, the Habs need more goal scorers, and Mike Hoffman would be available. I don't know. I don't think he's gonna re-sign with Florida. So I think a lot of teams should be interested in him. He's kind of like not top priority, but as soon as like these big names like Hall, Pietrangelo, Krug, and all of that, once these guys get signed, I think a lot of people should focus on Mike Hoffman. He scores a lot of goals ever since he's came in the league, and I think he's like a bit underrated at the moment, and that would be a great sign-in for the Habs because we need help up front, and any help we can get would benefit greatly to this team. All right, guys, so that was my thoughts on the possible free agent sign-in and possible trades that could happen for the Montreal Canadiens. Let me know in the comments if you guys agree with me, if you guys have other mock trades that we could do or talk about, and yeah. Tune in for the next video, I guess.